In this video, we will show you, among other highlights, QuickSnap, a new way to create your framework based on your designed Gingiva, which results in easy-to-assemble individual parts to go fully digital with all components of your partial denture. Now you can print or mill the framework and even the acrylic parts. And finally, everything will snap back together. Hi everyone, I'm Friedemann from exocad, and today I'll show you the new features available in PartialCAD 3.1 Rijeka. The software is kind of a giant toolbox where you have the freedom to create and design complex partials with ease. And thanks to your feedback, we were able to refine and improve many of those tools. We even added some new ones for workflows I had never imagined. Let us discover what is possible with PartialCAD 3.1 Rijeka. We prepared a new QuickSnap demo case for you and provided a material configuration that is necessary for this workflow. In the material selection, four different types of workflows are available to you. The normal QuickSnap way is creating two different parts of Gingiva that are separated into a bottom and a top layer around the framework. Alternatively, you can get only the top part of the Gingiva, or no Gingiva at all. Also, a flexible denture workflow is available. To start the QuickSnap workflow, we click on Design for our DentalCAD. Here we set up the teeth and design the Gingiva in advance. If a classical partial framework is what you need, you can skip this step and click on the PartialCAD button to start the design of your framework right away. Please follow the usual CAD steps for a case with Gingiva design. Then we set up our library teeth in the tooth placement step and proceed to freeforming. Here, we adapt our occlusion and proximal areas. To obtain the best results, it is recommended not to adapt the basal areas of the teeth now, to achieve the optimal adaptation to the framework and Gingiva later. When designing your Gingiva, it is important to keep in mind that this will be the final design for your partial framework, and the PartialCAD will use it exactly as it is designed here. With a double click, we finish the line drawing and make changes if necessary. If you want to use a semi-automatic finish line later, you can plan ahead by drawing the palatal area of your Gingiva accordingly. In the freeform Gingiva design step, you can use the smooth tool to flatten the palatal areas to achieve a smoother transition between metal framework and acrylic Gingiva parts. The design in the DentalCAD has been finished. We can select the next step, PartialCAD design, and close the DentalCAD, while the scene will be saved automatically. At first glance, you will notice the updated design, which is a bit closer to the design of our DentalCAD user interface. We added the refractory model as usual and continue to the next step. The Edit Blockout step is where we free up the areas of our clasps. A color coding indicates the area of retention accordingly. If we switch to the smooth mode, we can block out specific areas, for example, between teeth and gingiva. This provides a smoother transition and will be more comfortable for our patient. While drawing your connectors and mesh curve, let's summarize what is important for a QuickSnap case. The retention mesh should follow the gingiva and areas you want to connect to, but you get the option to automatically adapt it later. When you draw your major connector and want to use the semi-automatic finish line, it is important that the major connector should intersect with the gingiva, because this is where your finish line will be calculated in the end. That is why it's recommended to draw the curve in this specific way, even if you would normally not do it like this for a major connector. But for a QuickSnap case, this is very helpful. As always, if you want to design a skeletal plate, just draw a second closed curve on the inside of your major connector. And if you want a tissue stop for your retention meshes, just draw a second, smaller curve on your retention mesh. Let's have a look at our design by clicking on Next to get a preview of our meshes. Before we go into the settings, I'd like to show you a few changes. We can select and create our own presets by clicking on the three dots next to it. This is how you benefit from saved values and parameters and don't have to change or enter them every single time. Also, we added two new retention mesh patterns, round packed and round packed closer. The new Mesh Rim option creates a rim around your retention mesh, providing more stability and closing the holes around the edges. Below, you see the Fit Inside Part option. If the Gingiva is selected here, the retention mesh will only be created inside and not outside of it. Here you can see the option Semi-Auto Finish Line. By default, it is not activated, but in this case, it is, because we selected a saved preset below. This way, the software creates a finish line around the retention mesh wherever the main connector touches the gingival design. We added a new tab called Split Gingiva. Here you find all parameters you need for the QuickSnap design. For now, we will use the default settings and click Apply to start the calculation. You can see that three different buttons at the bottom are activated: Mesh, Connector, and Split Gingiva. This would allow you to calculate only those parts you are currently working on. You can see how the automatically created finish line is exactly following the previous designed gingiva. This is why it's important to shape the palatal area accordingly in the DentalCAD. Now we draw all our clasp curves quickly and fast forward to the next step. Here you can see that the clasp tips are colored differently in red and yellow, and in case you have a third end, it will be colored in cyan. This helps you to see at a glance which part you are changing if you want to set up tapered ends. Now you can also hover over the control points of your curve. If you hold down your shift key, the width of the clasp is displayed. And if you scroll with the mouse wheel, you change the width on the clasp or on the taper end dynamically. Also in this step, you can save your own clasp profile for later and reuse it as often as you want for further designs in the future. By using the clasp smoothing slider, you decide how straight or smooth the clasp is following the refractory surface. The clone tool now contains the clone blockout button down here at the bottom to change your blockout model before applying material. As always, in the Edit Wax step, we can smooth transitions to the finish line. For the occlusal rest, I recommend to activate the checkbox Blend Smoothly into Mask. If you activate the Wax Only mode, your model is hidden and you can edit your framework even from the bottom. The next step, Assemble Parts, is new. Here, the calculation of all intersecting elements takes place. For example, to create tooth pockets and to split the gingiva in separate parts. After the calculation is done, teeth, gingiva, and gingiva bottom appear in the Show Height menu. You can still modify the partial framework design, but these parts will not adapt to further changes. Let's have a look at the new Cut View tool we implemented with PartialCAD 3.1 Rijeka by clicking on the button next to Apply. Thanks to distinct colors, we can see clearly that the gingiva has been split into two different parts and fit together precisely in the end. Various settings in the Build step allow you to enhance your output even further, especially if you're within the Expert mode. Once everything is calculated and finished, we are ready for production. But there is one more feature I want to show you. It's called the Exploded View. If you click on this new button, your design will explode, offering a unique view to see how all these parts fit together. Let's open another case and jump right to Add Parts. This step includes a new window called Part Options. All the imported files from the DentalCAD are listed. Here you can enable or remove parts and decide which role this part plays in your design. If you select one element with a click, it will be visualized in orange. Now you can choose if this part should be a reference, non-editable, solid or hollow wax, or part of your refractory. Alternatively, you can right-click on the part inside the Show Height menu. With a click on Apply, this object will change according to your selection. After importing parts manually, the possibility to move, rotate, or scale objects is also new. Finally, the Retention Posts option had a few changes. With a click on Use File, we open one of the new posts. If the checkbox Actual Size is activated, we get the exact dimension the file was saved in. Alternatively, we can also edit the dimensions within the Settings menu. Here you can modify the length, the thickness and the end thickness individually. If you select the uniform scale, some of the options will be grayed out and the slider scales everything at once. Another available slider is the surface offset to intersect the post with the framework. A grayed option is the align to surface option. This way, the post follows the shape of your framework. The preview opacity slider helps to see through the posts. And by holding down the control key, the rotation of the post can be modified manually. Now we have seen a few of the new tools in PartialCAD 3.1 Rijeka. And there are many more to help you design whatever framework you can think of. I hope this video has sparked your creativity and that you are as excited for this version as we are. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.
If you'd like to learn more, our resellers are always happy to help. And in case you are looking for one-to-one training from one of our exocad experts, visit our webshop shop.exocad.com and book your personalized training online. Select from a variety of topics like DentalCAD or Exoplan Core Basics, release highlight introductions, module how-tos, question and answer sessions, system checkups, and more. Our technical help desk specialist will be happy to answer all your questions and provide you with a certificate and recording to make your learning experience as beneficial as possible for you.